Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. Today topic is V-Ray render settings. V-Ray 5 render settings in 3ds Max are quite easy because most of the work is already done for you. If you are still using previous versions of V-Ray, I strongly recommend to update it now. But these V-Ray 5 render settings will work on previous versions of V-Ray 4 too. In this V-Ray 5 render settings tutorial, you will learn how to quickly set low resolution settings for test renders, how to set V-Ray frame buffer, how to set V-Ray brute force, light cache, progressive image sampler, V-Ray denoiser render element, how to quickly set high resolution settings for final quality renders. Bonus tip. So without any further ado, let's get started. In order to use V-Ray 5 renderer, you need to select it as your current renderer. Open the render setup window by clicking here or press F10. Set target to production rendering mode. Set renderer to V-Ray 5. Do not select GPU. Select V-Ray 5. With the introduction of the new V-Ray denoiser and progressive image sampler, I will say that the best option to render low or high resolution images is brute force, light cache, denoiser, and progressive image sampler. How to quickly set low resolution settings for test renders. Click Render Element tab. Click Add, click V-Ray Denoiser, next click GI tab. Make sure your primary engine is Brute Force and your secondary engine is Light Cache. Now open Light Cache rollout and change your subdivisions to 500. Now click V-Ray tab. Open Image Sampler Rollout. Make sure your image sampler type is set to Progressive. Next, open Progressive Image Sampler Rollout. Change Noise Threshold to 0. Render Time. It sets the maximum render time in minutes, and after reaching this time, V-Ray will stop rendering the image. Let's set the value to 1 and render. You can see that the V-Ray has stopped rendering after 1 minute and 19.7 seconds. It's okay if your render takes a few more seconds because it has to apply denoiser and finalize image. But if you watch closely, it has some noise. You can see here too. Next, set the render time to 3 minutes and render. You can see that the V-Ray has stopped rendering after 3 minutes and 19.8 seconds. Compare both the renders. One minute, three minute. You can see that the result has improved a lot. When the render time was 1 minute, you can see the noise here. And when the render time was 3 minutes, you can see the noise has reduced a lot. 1 minute, you can see these spots here and the render quality. Now 3 minutes, you can see it's a lot better. You can keep increasing the render time to make the result better. But in test rendering, we have to do a lot of renders to check lighting and shading. Therefore, I normally don't care about the quality of the image and want fast renders. So set the render time between 1 to 3 minutes and enjoy quick renders. I normally set it to 1 minute. How to quickly set high resolution settings for final renders? Since we have changed the V-Ray render settings, so I will reset V-Ray render settings by changing renderer to scanline renderer, and then again I will change it back to V-Ray 5. This way my V-Ray settings are again set to default settings. Next, click render elements and add V-Ray denoiser. If V-Ray denoiser is already added, then select it, delete it, and add V-Ray denoiser again to change it back to its default settings. Next, select V-Ray denoiser, and in the V-Ray denoiser parameters rollout, change the preset from default to mild. If you remember, in low resolution settings, we keep the preset to default values, but this time we are keeping it to mild preset. The reason for this is that denoiser detects the area where noise is present in the rendered image and smooths them out. Let's see an example. If I turn off denoiser in this image, you can see the noise present here. This was the actual render. But when I apply denoiser on it, it is actually going to smooth out a lot of result and makes my result better. Since we are rendering high resolution images, so I keep the mild preset, which is less smooth than the default preset. Next, click GI tab. Open Global Illuminations rollout. Make sure your primary engine is set to brute force and your secondary engine is set to light cache. Now open light cache rollout. If you're rendering full HD images, then for exterior renders with normal detail, I keep the light cache between 1500 to 2500. For interior images with high detail, I keep the light cache between 2000 to 3000. If you are rendering extremely high images like 4000 into 4000 or greater pixels, then make sure the subdivision of your light cache is not less than half of it. Example, for 4000 into 4000 pixels, set the light cache between 2000 to 4000. For our image, I will keep it to 2500. One more thing, if you are doing animations, then change the preset from still to animation and use a high number of subdivs. Next, click V-Ray tab. Open Image Sampler Anti-Aliasing rollout. It is extremely important as it impacts the render quality versus render time of your image. The main purpose of image sampling is to improve anti-aliasing. If you don't know about anti-aliasing, let me know in the comments. Now render the scene. Since the introduction of V-Ray Next, we have progressive image sampler, which renders the whole image progressively in passes and improves the detail with each pass like this. You can see here, right now it's pass 1 and the image has been progressively being improved. You can see pass 2, again here pass 2. As the passes will increase, the image will get more and more clear. You can still do bucket rendering, but now I use progressive because I can see the whole image progress as it renders. Plus, progressive image rendering is easy to use. Next, open progressive image sampler rollout. The only two parameters to adjust in progressive sampler are render time and noise threshold. Again, set the noise threshold to 0 and render time to 1 and render. You can see that the V-Ray has stopped rendering after 1 minute and 40 seconds. But our image is noisy. We know it from the low resolution settings that it will take few more seconds to complete the render. Now set the value to 5 minutes and render. Again, we can see that the V-Ray has stopped rendering after 5 minutes and 17 seconds. The result has improved a lot from the previous time. We can keep increasing the render time like this to improve the result. But if you are doing final renders and render time is not a problem for you, furthermore, you want full image quality without noise, then disable render time by typing 0 here. Reset noise threshold to its original default value of 0.01. This is the value when you first open V-Ray. Noise threshold. It sets the desired level in the image. Since the render time is disabled, therefore V-Ray stops rendering when the noise threshold value of 0.01 is reached. Lower noise threshold values will give better result but increase render time. So, if you want to decrease noise and increase image quality, then decrease noise threshold to 0.005. Mostly, this value gives you a smooth result. Render and compare. You can clearly see that the image quality has improved a lot. But look at the render time. It is 20 minutes and 1.8 seconds. So, this is how I set my high quality renders. Brute force to default values, light cache between 1500 to 3000, V-Ray denoiser to mild preset. In progressive image sampler, either set render time or I use noise threshold between 0.01 to 0.005. Before I give my final bonus tip, I would like you guys to check out my two other playlists, V-Ray for 3ds Max, V-Ray Next for 3ds Max. They have easy to follow V-Ray tutorials for 3ds Max with easy explanation. Almost all the V-Ray Next tutorials will work with V-Ray 5 too, but if some option changes in V-Ray 5, I will mention them in comments. For example, 3ds Max, best way to start learning V-Ray Next for beginners. If you go down to the comments, I have written here, important info, V-Ray quick settings dialog box has been removed from V-Ray 5 and GI is turned on by default. So if you are using V-Ray 5, then skip section 3 and move to section 4, V-Ray lights. But if you see other tutorials like exterior lighting, materials, they will work with V-Ray 5 too. Bonus tip, how to bring down the intensity of V-Ray highlight burns like these. You can see V-Ray highlight burn. Till V-Ray Next, I go to color mapping rollout to lower intensity of my highlight burns. I change the type to exponential, HSV exponential, or decrease the burn value of Reinhardt. This is totally okay, but it has one disadvantage. If you want to change the highlight burn, you have to render again. But in VDA 5, you don't need to change the color mapping at all. Instead, go to VDA frame buffer, click the green plus sign, and add exposure. Change highlight burn. You can see that how easy it is to bring down highlight burns in V-Ray. Without exposure, I can change the highlight burn as much as I want. I just want little bit highlight burn, so I will increase it and make it like this. Plus, there are other settings too. If I want to change the contrast, which normally I do, I will change it to 0.1 to increase a little bit sharpness. Now see, without exposure, with exposure. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like my videos, give it a like. If you love my videos, comment below, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye bye.